May the one who is supreme in power, blessing, and glory bless this Chatan, Michael, and this Kala, Rachel. This moment is a merging of two paths of life into one. Ruchim Habaim, we welcome you to a loving marriage.
Rachel and I met on J-Date, actually, and we had a lot in common. You know, we both have lots of nieces and nephews, and that pretty much was our first common element that drew us together, and yeah, just kind of went from there.
When we met last day, I knew you were my...
Thank goodness Rachel and Mike found each other. There's such deep love and understanding between them that they sometimes seem to read each other's thoughts, which is good because they're both people of few words.
Rachel wrote me a beautiful note last night, which I will not read. And in it, a large part of the note was all about her feeling for Michael and how happy she was to have found him and his what he means to her. So, of course, I cried. What could I do?
I wanna tell you how much.
Let the mountains of Israel dance. Let the gates of Jerusalem ring with the sounds of joy, song, merriment, and delight. The voice of the groom and the voice of the bride, and the happy shouts of their friends and companions. We praise you, God, who brings bride and groom together to rejoice in each other.
Planning the wedding, and as we were approaching it, all I could think of was one phrase that kept. It was from a song that we used to sing on Shabbos in my grandparents' house. Zehayom asar anai nagila v'nismechabo. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be happy in it. And really, that's that just kept playing over and over and over in my head.
Mike, do you agree to abide by the terms and obligations of this ketubah and to live with Rachel as a proper Jewish husband? Okay, great. And Rachel, I'm going to ask you similarly, do you agree to abide by the commitments outlined in this ketubah and to live with Mike as a proper Jewish wife?
Yes, I do. People spend so much time every single day.
A few days ago, during the rehearsal, she said, "Dad, you got to be funny." Now, I know, and many people who know me, wit is not my strong point. And if you really want to ask, he'll tell you the drop of a hat. Jay will corroborate this anytime. But I had an association when she said that, "You can do it, Dad," because she said it many times, and I had an association to something that happened at the CNE, and the theme of this is the CNE, and she said to me, I want you to go to where the pool thing is. I want you to win that the big tiger for me." Now, I'm not Minnesota Fats. She said it in such a way that really, you know, she wasn't giving me a pep talk. She just expected that I could do it. She said, "You can do it, Dad." The thing was that you had to get all the balls in sequentially to get this prize. So at the break, I immediately got one ball into the pocket, and then one after another, they all went in until I was at the last ball. I had the cue lined up with a ball, which was lined up with a pocket, and just behind it there was Rachel, who really didn't question. She knew when she says you can do it, you know, she really thinks there's no question about it, you can do it. And I did it.
Like a handless clock with numbers, an infinite of time. No, not the forever found, only in the mind.
There have been many you can do it dads from Rachel. Rachel herself could do it. She has in the last year or so really done many things that have been dramatic in terms of her life. She graduated with distinction from her course. She was picked up at the Peel School Board. She moved into her apartment, her condo, and today you saw she's a beautiful bride. So, Rachel, you can do it too.
A moment to reflect on where we are. This place has some significance for our family. The Palais Royale has been here for a long time, and I learned recently that my grandmother, the Bibi Helen, used to come here on dates with my grandfather, Jack, in the 40s when Duke Ellington and Count Basie used to play here. They used to come here when they were courting, and that marriage is 72 years long and counting, so.
Michael and Rachel, you share such a strong commitment to the value of family. You've spoken to me so deeply about that, how important it is, and that is so crucial as you formally establish your own family this day. You both so clearly admire each other's caring nature. It's such a blessing that you found each other.
First of all, I want to tell you that I love my wife. It's the best thing I ever did.
I agree with that.
And I hope that Rachel and Mike have at least as good an experience as I had with her. And I will continue to have. She's done so much for tonight, and she has every one of you, she's considered what she can do to make you comfortable and for you to have a good time. So have a good time for her.
Mike and Rachel, I offer you some advice from my 12 years. Mike, for your advice, I'm going to paraphrase the modern day philosopher, Mr. Woody Allen, who said that happiness in a marriage is always remembering this. In your house, you're the boss. Rachel just makes the decisions.
Please don't. Mike, you should take a page out of that sentiment. You can do it, Mike. You did it. Yeah, as Susan said, you know, you persevered. I wonder, 8 years he hung around. And you make a lovely couple, and together I think you can both do a lot. Thank you.
Yeah, our love will grow old. Yeah, our love will grow.
Tonight is a glorious, wonderful celebration. It's also, to me, a technicality, because, Mike, it's been years now that you have been supporting Rachel and loving her through ups and downs and doing everything that a partner does. I've only known you as my sister's partner, as a decent and gentle and caring person, and as a mensch. And I couldn't be more thrilled with who she found and who she chose, and to welcome you into our family. I've had a chance to get to know some of the other line ones, and I can tell through all the ridicule, because that's the language that I speak to, how much they love you. So I'll say it. I'll say it because they can. I love you, and I'm happy for you to be my brother, and I want to welcome you into this family. Thank you so much.
Rachel, you're a kind and considerate person. I want to give you a definition of marriage that was told to me once and has stuck with me for a while. Rachel, marriage means to adopt an overgrown male child who is no longer the responsibility of his parents. He's all yours now.
Rachel was born on a Monday morning. She was such a sweet baby. And she grew into a delicate little kid who turned into a sensitive teenager who at some point became the glorious weirdo you see before you today.
As for Rachel, she is a beautiful and amazing person. She is a total blessing in my life. And Rachel has taught me many, many things. She has taught me what it means to persevere and what it means to be brave and to keep on going. And I love and admire my daughter more than she knows.
Before Mike, to be in Rachel's inner circle, like to properly really be exposed to and understand the force of nature that is Rachel, your last name probably had to either be Friedman or Brown. But Rachel saw almost from her first date that Mike was someone who was worth it. And Mike rewarded Rachel's belief that he was someone she could really be herself with and really open up to by turning out to be a total weirdo too.
She has terrific choices in terrific taste in her choice of spouse and his family. The line ones have been wonderful, wonderful to join with, to plan with, to work with. And I look forward to many, many more occasions on which we can celebrate together. I'm not pressuring anybody, but you know, there could be something else that could happen.
Finally, to Rachel, Mike asked me to thank you on behalf of him for turning up today, for saying yes today. And he asked me specifically to say in words what he usually puts in texts and Facebook messages, that you made him very happy today and he loves you very much. Rachel, I love you. You mean absolutely everything to me. You made me the happiest person ever. And I look forward to every moment we spend together for the rest of our lives, except when there's a hockey game on TV. I love you.
Away. You have always been there for me. You are the very best personal assistant I could ever ask for. I would like to take a moment to apologize for the bridezilla behavior exhibited throughout the planning of this wedding by my mother. Truthfully, Mom, you have been my greatest inspiration, and this wedding would not have been possible without you. Mom, you are truly amazing, and your dedication to this family is incredible. This wedding was truly a massive undertaking, and Mike and I could not be happier with how things turned out. Mom, Dad, Sam, and Marion, we love you and thank you for everything.
Hey now, hey now, hey.
Mom and Dad, you can't pick your parents, but I'm glad I got stuck with you because you've given me advice and examples of how to live my life with Rachel going forward in our marriage. I couldn't have asked for better parents. I thank you for everything you've done for me, and I love both of you.
Conclude a Jewish wedding, as you know, with the smashing of a glass. This act reminds us of the broken souls in this world who yet wait for a day of celebration and joy. As we include them in our thoughts, we ask God to make their lives whole again and to bring to them the happiness that Rachel and Michael enjoy today. Between now and then, let us pray that however many pieces this glass may break into, so may Rachel and Michael's happiness be multiplied. Mazel tov!
We always win the fight. Your left hook and my right.
I'm glad that Rachel and Mike found each other so I could have all these new cousins.
Ladies and gentlemen, finally, let's give this wonderful couple the toast they deserve. Please raise your glasses in honor of my brother and his beautiful new wife. Mazel tov.